My favourite new feature in Messages is the ability to send a message at a time you want to in the future. A little bit like when you schedule send an email to appear at 8 o'clock the next morning, you can now do that with Messages as well. No more forgetting people's birthdays, you can schedule it to send whenever you want to. So here, for an example, I've got a message thread with my wife, and I'm going to leave a little message that I want to send in a couple of days' time. I will say I would generally like to hope that I can remember my wife's birthday, but this isn't actually her birthday as an example. It's all made up and pretend, so go with the flow here. Now I've typed that message, I don't want to send it straight away. So what I'm going to do is press the plus button on the left-hand side, and then choose the new Send Later option. If it's not here, you might need to press More first for it to appear. Now I can choose the date and the time the message gets sent as easily as this. When I press the blue Send button, the message will appear in a dotted line and the recipient won't have received it yet. But this means I can then schedule another message of a different time perhaps, maybe just like this, and send that as well. And you can see now there's a queue of messages ready to go on that morning. But I can also make changes before they get sent. I can press Edit, and I can edit the message itself, or the date or time it's being sent. This is a really, really useful feature, and it is very easy to use as well, which is brilliant. Just press that plus button, and then Send Later, and you're good to go. And if you want to go back to texting normally and sending in real time, simply press the little X on that blue date and time banner, and you'll be back to normal texting mode. And that's not all that's changed in Messages this year. I spent my summer playing with iOS 18, and I've made a ton of quick tip videos on my channel down below, but excitingly I've also written in my first ebook. I've called it 100 Quick Tips for iOS 18, and if you follow the link below, I promise you're going to find things that you never knew your phone could do now you've updated to iOS 18. I'll see you next time.